Arriva da Città del Capo in Sudafrica questo catamarano Exquisite 50.
Coming from Cape Town, South Africa, this Exquisite 50 catamaran has been designed to travel anywhere in the world with no limits. Rudolf Junker designed it in conjunction with the yard's technical office. It is 15 meters and 44 centimeters long. It's 1 meter and 45 in depth, 8 meters wide, and weighs 18,000 kilos. It has two 80 horsepower engines.
Ma quello che è interessante è la scelta che è stata fatta per avere il meglio per quanto riguarda tutti gli impianti, pannelli solari.
But what is interesting is their choice of getting the best out of all the systems: the solar panels, the desalinator, and the cautious double check of all services, even with the digital equipment, sending it back to the site so that even when the boat is far away, they know what the conditions are and, if necessary, can intervene in maintenance problems.
La costruzione di vetro resina, gli scafi sono infusi con resina vinyl ester.
It's built from fiberglass. The hulls are infused vinyl ester resin and foam, while the superstructure is a traditional laminate.
Di questo catamarano sono già stati costruiti 6 esemplari.
There have already been 6 of these catamarans built, priced at $1,250,000. Fully equipped, the boatyard is also working on a 56-foot motor catamaran that we will see soon.
Eccoci all'interno di Exquisite 50. Tutti I mobili sono realizzati.
All the furniture is made with real wood inside the Exquisite 50, laminated onto very light structures. We are used to seeing this system on racing boats, but keeping the weight down on a catamaran with all that there is on board is not exactly easy.
Molto dotata come al solito la cucina.
The kitchen is very well equipped as usual, which among other things has an Italian gas hob.
Particolari che contano. Vi mostriamo una soluzione che
It's the details that count. This wouldn't be feasible on a monohull. Drawers. But here's the best bit. Look how much stowage space there is for kitchen utensils and food supplies.
Il frigo principale è una colonna in tre sezioni.
The main fridge is a three-sectioned column, which is an increasingly popular choice because it is incredibly efficient, with its ice maker, of course.
Ecco un tavolo da carteggio, una zona per il navigatore.
Here's the chart table, the navigator's area as it should be. You've all the electronics you need. There is a view to the bow, and in the case of ocean sailing, you can control the route with the autopilot's remote control.
Nello scafo di sinistra sono realizzate due cabine.
On the left, there are two double cabins with two large bathrooms that have separate shower cabins.
Lo scafo destro è destinato tutto all'armatore, una grandissima cabina armatoriale con un
The right hull is intended for the owner, with a large master cabin which has a huge bathroom. One of the characteristics of this boat is having these side windows next to the bed, which allow you to enjoy the scenery, the bay, the view, even the coziest of moments.
Dove è possibile sono realizzati cassetti.
There are drawers, wardrobes, anywhere you can put them, and they hold everything, really, so it's good for long cruises. Here's the vanity.
Qui sotto è nascosta una parte dell'impianto elettrico elettronico.
Part of the electronic system is hidden below it, all bypassable as to be expected, to ensure safety, even with a small failure.
Ecco ancora armati.
Here are some more cabinets. They know this owner's desire to sail a lot and a long way.
Altri particolari.
Other details for life in the open air. This bench can be raised, so it becomes a backrest and is very comfortable to sit here. And this is a real accessory, something that all the big boats should have: a cylinder compressor.
Eccoci nella postazione del
This is the helmsman station. You can control the whole boat from here. Electric winches to adjust the sails. Tachometer for the two engines. Screen with the chart plotter. You do not need anything else. The windscreen reminds me of a car windscreen, but it's protective. Above me, the shade can be taken down if you want to feel the wind. It is interesting to see how, on a boat that is designed to be light in all its details, has such a rigid rail, though it will certainly reassure those who must go up to the bow. The solar panels can deliver up to 60 amps per hour when the sun is shining, which is a lot. And look here, a rainwater collector. The sail plan is a pretty large square top, plus it has self-tacking jib that will face the most intense winds and an almost code zero Genoa for lots of slack.